is adventure. Here's romance. Here's O. Henry's famous Robin Hood of the Old West, a Cisco Kid.
Treasures, O face of death, smite those who would defile the gods of the Aztecs and steal what has been entrusted to thy care. It is I who speaks, Quetzal, the last of the high priests. Quetzal, who has heard the voice of his ancestors calling him. Guard well my tomb, O face of death.
Matter?
I got a funny feeling someone's watching us, Barry.
Oh, I don't see anyone. I think you're just getting a bad case of nerves.
It's this blasted country. It's giving me the creeps.
You just couldn't wait to gun him down, could you?
What's the matter? You're getting chicken?
Cut it off, you lame brains! Get your hands off that gun.
I won't forget this, Barry.
I said cut it out. We've got a job to do. We're going to stick together. We get it done. Get it?
That chance we've got with the professor gone.
Yeah, smart guy. We'll take a gander over there. There are the peaks that we've been searching for. The three peaks that form a perfect triangle.
You're right. At the base of the center one on the south side, we'll find the entrance to the tomb.
Yeah. The tomb of the Quetzal, the last of the Aztec priests. Well, what do you got to say now?
Plenty. You still had no right to kill the old man.
We're after treasure, ain't we?
Would have gotten it anyhow. All he wanted was the glory, the reputation of having found the tomb.
That's a lot of tripe.
If I'd known this meant murder, I'd have had no part of it.
Oh, Robert Pete, cut out this walla walla. Well, let's get out of this blasted country. It'll take us the rest of the day to get up to them peaks. Now, come on!
That box must be it.
Holy mackerel! Gold and jewels. A whole bushel of them.
It's all ours.
Face of death. The professor warned us about it.
Oh, calm down. You didn't believe that bug he told you, did
Look!
You?
I'm getting out of here.
What's the matter, Pancho?
Oh, I don't know, Cisco. Every time I ride through this country, all over, I get the geese pimples.
It's pretty dreary, all right. We'll soon be out of it.
Look, Cisco.
Get your canteen, Pancho.
Mm-hmm. Santos.
What's the matter, Pancho?
Look what I find in his hand, Cisco.
Face of death. Face of death. No, no, get out of here, man.
Take it easy. Take it easy. Nobody's going to hurt you. Here, take a little more water. Now, who are you? What happened to you?
Here, where you find the jewels?
Professor Spencer. Aztec's treasure. No, 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 take it away. Don't let it get me. Tell Spencer's daughter. White one. Tell her that.
He's still alive, Pancho. Let's get him to a doctor.
Yeah, I'll get the horses.
Yes?
Spencer?
Yes.
I'm Professor John Ferris, a friend of your father's. He asked me to meet him here.
Oh, won't you come in?
Thank you.
I'm awfully sorry, Professor, but my dad hasn't returned yet.
Returned? You mean he's left on the expedition already?
Oh, yes. He's been gone about 2 weeks now.
Oh, dear. What a disappointment. I'd counted so much on making the trip with him.
Well, Dad did get off a little sooner than he expected. Are you an archaeologist, too?
Oh, no, just a prosaic professor of mathematics. Oh, you have no idea what a dull subject it is to teach year in and year out. To students who have no respect for its value.
You have my sympathy.
Oh, thank you. I didn't intend to sound pathetic, but I've always envied your father, traveling most of the time, searching out strange places. Ah, oh, well, I expect it's my fate to be glued to a desk. Have you any idea when your father will return?
Oh, I've no idea. Excuse me, please.
Miss Spencer?
Yes?
How do you do? We'd like to have a talk with you. It's of great importance. My name is Cisco Kid. This is my good friend, Pancho.
Pancho Miguel Fernandez Gonzalez de Conejo.
Come in, please.
Thank you.
Won't you sit down? This is Professor Ferris.
How do you do?
What did you wish to talk to me about?
Well, about 3 days ago, Pancho and I found a man half dead up in the hills.
Yeah, we tried to get him to a doctor, but he died in the trail.
He mentioned your father's name, about some treasure and something about the face of death. But he was so disconnected, we couldn't understand what he was trying to tell us.
Yeah, he had a scar on top of his face on this side. You know him?
A scar? Oh, that must have been Barry. He and two other guides went on an expedition with my father.
Well, we found these in his hands.
Sure. And I found Quetzal's tomb.
But where can my father be? And what about Lou and Jordan? Why did they separate from Barry?
You remember my Uncle Tito, one time he got his legs all tangled up at a wedding. He didn't get home for 2 or 3 weeks.
What do you know about this face of death, Miss Spencer?
Well, it's an Aztec legend that whoever looks at it will die suddenly.
Oh, Santos, Cisco, you think this Barry, he sees it?
Have you any idea where your father expected to find this tomb that the professor mentioned?
Well, I heard him say something about a peak. A peak between two peaks that formed a perfect triangle when seen from the north.
It's the Three Sisters, Pancho.
You know where it is?
Yes, about 125 miles to the north of here.
I must find Dad and make sure he's all right. Will you take me there?
Well, it's a pretty rugged country for a girl to travel through, Miss Spencer. Even Pancho and I have never been able to make the trip all the way through.
May I go along, too?
No, you're too old. It's a pretty hard trip.
Oh, please. Professor Spencer is a close friend of mine.
All right. We'll leave early in the morning. I think you better put those jewels in the hotel safe.
I will. Thanks. And you, too. I'll feel much better when I know Dad is safe.
Con permiso.
Bye.
I was in the hotel lobby when the girl brung them down, Rance, and take it from me, those jewels are worth a fortune.
Very interesting.
And we won't have any trouble at all getting them from that crummy old safe.
That's just like you. Can't see the trees for the forest.
What do you mean?
Why should we settle for a handful of jewels when old man Opportunity is trying to kick our door down?
What in Hades are you talking about?
The treasure, where that stuff must have come from. We'll settle for that.
And I guess you know where it is, huh?
No, but Miss Spencer should. We'll persuade her to talk and then go after it.
Maybe she won't persuade.
Just leave that to me. You and Eddie bring her over here in the morning.
Mind telling me how?
Tell her father turned up sick. It was too dangerous to move him.
How far is it to this cabin?
Oh, not far, miss.
We better stop and get the doctor.
Oh, that ain't necessary. Your pa's more tuckered out than sick, and he's mighty anxious to see you.
You not going with her, Cisco?
As far as I know, she is, Pancho. Unless she had something else to do first.
Tell Cisco and Pancho, I'd better tell them where I'm going.
You see what I see?
Let's get our horses.
The lobo got away.
You feel all right?
Yes, thanks. Just a little shaken up.
Hey, you're lucky you didn't broke your neck.
Who were those men?
I don't know. They said that my father had turned up at a cabin up in the hills, too weak to move, and had sent for me.
Oh, so that's it.
That's what?
Someone has the bright idea that you know where the Aztec treasure is hidden.
How you know that, Cisco? Nobody told you.
I'll draw you a map when we get back to town.
What I want with a map, Cisco?
O thou who watchest over all things, speed well my shafts, and make them strike true.
What is it, Pancho?
Oh, Mr. Ferris, I don't know. It feels like somebody's breathing on top of the back of my neck.
Ah, it's just your imagination, Pancho.
Maybe Cisco... Cisco, listen.
I don't hear anything.
Me too. I don't hear something. Not even the little bird singing. This place is like the graveyard.
Pancho, you're going to make everybody nervous.
Cisco, I can't help it. This country give me the heebie-jeebles.
Oh, dear, do you think we ought to turn back?
Oh, there is nothing to be afraid of, Professor. Pancho kids all the time. Right now he's playing like he's being scared. Right, Pancho?
I don't know, Cisco. Maybe because I'm so hungry, huh? If we had something good to eat, like, some enchiladas, some carne con chile, some tripas de leche, and some frijoles on top, then I wouldn't be so nervous, eh? Hey, you gonna make camp here?
All right, Pancho, we'll make camp.
Hunger is a wonderful sauce for the appetite, Cisco.
Cisco, you know those eyes, I can still feel them on the back of my neck.
Good heavens, what was that?
It was a woman screaming.
No, it's a mountain lion. Pancho, watch the horses. Here you are, Professor, just in case.
Oh, no, I wouldn't know what to do with it. I never handle a firearm.
Not the scream of a mountain lion.
It was the Indian.
He must be the one that has been watching us.
My goodness, you let him escape. Now we'll all be scalped in our sleep. Why didn't you shoot him?
Boy? Professor, we don't use guns on boys.
Well, you're absolutely right, Cisco. I'm sorry. I didn't mean what I said.
What would a young boy like that be doing out here all by himself?
Pancho told you. This is a very strange country, Miss Spencer. And the people that live in it, they're also very strange. Well, come on. Let's break camp. There they are, the three sisters.
They look so bleak and terrible. Do you think we have any chance of finding those men, Cisco?
All we can do is hope and keep trying.
Cisco, what I find?
It's a skull, Pancho.
That's somebody who used to be, eh? Ooh, I don't like the way you look at me, Cisco.
Put it down. We'll bury him later.
This is very interesting, Cisco. These mountains were thrust up ages ago by an underwater volcanic eruption.
I thought you were a professor of mathematics.
Oh, I am, but I've always been very much interested in this sort of thing.
Cisco, the bones of this place make a tombstone hard to find. Cisco, I find it. I will get some greasewood and make a torch, huh?
No,
he's an Indian boy.
You have saved my life, Dark Eagle. Therefore, I give you warning. You must not enter the tomb of Quetzal.
Why not?
It is written that all who look on the face of death will die. Go now with your friends.
But we're looking for this young lady's father and his two friends.
They are dead. Their leader was slain by one of the others. I found this on the body before I buried him.
Hey, who you are?
I am Tekle, descendant of Quetzal, guardian of the tomb. I am the last of my people.
You mean you live here? Little boy like you, all by yourself?
With such a treasure to guard, weren't you afraid?
A son of the Aztecs knows no fear.
The treasure?
Is it still in the cave?
Reach for it! Get up high. Higher. Never mind the Indian. Get their guns.
I'm not armed.
Remember me, sister? Now I'll take care of you for butting in where you had no business.
Enough of that, Digger. Go get something for a torch. Hold it.
Look, Rance, that box over there. I bet that's where the treasure is.
Not so fast, Digger. You three, go over by that wall and face it. I heard that Indian warn you about the face of death. Any idea what it is?
I'm a stranger in these parts myself.
Come on, Rance, let's open the box.
No, I think we'll let our friend here do it for us. Well, get busy. Cisco, don't stand there.
Hey, the Indian boy, he used a blowgun.
Let's get him out of here, Pancho.
Here my canteen, Cisco.
All right, Pancho.
I gave back the life I owed you, oh, Dark Eagle.
Don't try to talk now.
Promise you will bury me here with my ancestors.
I promise.
Take the treasure with you. It is the will of the gods. The face of death is finished.
Pancho, there's some dynamite in my saddlebags. Get it.
What are you going to do, Cisco?
I'm going to seal the cave after we bury Tecla.
But what about the treasure?
We'll leave it here. It has been the cause of a lot of bloodshed. It'll cause more if we take it with us.
You are right, Cisco.
All very noble of you. But I must disagree with any such trite sentiment.
Well, Cisco, you've got our guns.
I must compliment you on their balance. They're fine weapons.
Professor Ferris, are you out of your mind?
Sorry to disillusion you, my dear, but the name is Chanfield. Sam Chanfield.
Sam Chanfield?
Yeah, Slippery Sam, huh? Card player, forger, and killer.
And bank robber, too. Don't forget that. And perhaps, my dear, not too bad an actor.
Oh, Cisco, I feel like such a fool. He told me he was a friend of my father's, and I believed him.
We all believed him.
And now,
get a couple of rope, quick. Yeah, what are you going to say now?
Seems I was a trifle premature.
What do you mean, Cisco, that premature?
Pancho, do you remember when we were kids and we went to school together?
Eh?
And you boasted that you could whip Tony Garcia?
Eh?
And instead, Tony Garcia whipped you?
Oh, Cisco, you have to remind me about that.
Well, Pancho, when you boasted that you could whip Tony, you were premature. You spoke too quick.
Yeah, but Tony was premature because he hit too quick.
Oh, Pancho.
Oh, Cisco!
Goodbye, amigos.
See you soon.